Well, listen, Jeremy, wherever you are, you're live on Max Television. Today is the Deluxe Professional Boxing League week number 8. You all welcome. We are getting ready for the first bout of the evening, but we want to say kudos to our sponsors, Deluxe Paint Painting with Champion, Renault, Techno, Max My, you know, and all the sponsors who are supporting us to come your way live with the Boxing League. Now, the first bout of the evening. It is going to be a light heavyweight contest over 8 rounds. Now, officials for this bout. Judge 1, Nathaniel O'Bain. Judge 2, Davis Mills. And Judge 3, Clement Ashon. And the man in charge of this fight is Michael Nikwe. Ladies and gentlemen, let's welcome the boxer, Patrick Billon. Let's welcome the boxer, Ni Achite Labi.
Shut down empire.
Manga renew up. The years ago, there you go. Manga renew up. The beer to a moon pop. I do my own.
Well, listen, gentlemen, we are now set for the first bout of the evening, the Luxe Professional Boxing League. And this is an international light heavyweight contest over 8 rounds. Now, officials for this bout, Judge 1, Nathaniel O'Bain, Judge 2, David Mills, and Judge 3, Clement Sean. Now, introducing the boxer fighting out from the blue corner this evening. Spotted in the red and white trunks with black and white shoe and blue gloves to match. This is the boxer with a weight of 175 pounds. And this is the man with the official record of 3 fights, 2 wins, just 1 defeat. And this is the man from Douala in Cameroon, presenting to you the boxer, Patrick Billon. Switching over to the red corner, and this is one of the tallest boxers Ghana has ever produced. From the beach boxing gym here in Accra, with a weight of 180 pounds, and this is the man with the official of 2 fights, 2 wins, no defeat, no draw. And this is the man presenting to you the boxer, Ni Achite Labi. And the man in charge of this fight is Michael Nikwe.
All right, gentlemen, I expect a clean fight. Protect yourself at all times. And whatever I say, you must obey. Touch up. God bless.
It's 8, and this is the first bout of the evening. My name is Princeton, and I'll be supported here heavily by my usual suspects, as in Cecil Niteko is here with us, and also is Naneao Techi as well. And we'll be running you through all the action here tonight. On fight night 8 is the first bout of the evening, and is the first round of a tie between Ni Achite Labi and Patrick Belong. Patrick Belong is in the red trunks and Ni Ashilabi, quite a tall figure we have here, fighting in the black and red trunks. This is a light heavyweight contest and it's scheduled for 6 rounds, I want to believe. And as we usually do here, we'll be running you through what you need to know in terms of the Deluxe Professional Boxing League. Of course, it's almost always live every fortnight here on Max TV. Proud producers, proud sponsors, and of course, the proud promoters of the Ghana Deluxe Professional Boxing League. It's the first round, and you can call it a Ghana-Cameroon affair. Patrick Belong in the red trunks, coming all the way from the capital of Cameroon. And he's facing Ghana's Ni Ashilabi. Early exchanges here. Nothing really to write home about as the two boxers would want to size each other up. But of course, IMAX Media in pole position to bring you nothing but the best in professional and amateur boxing, ably supported by Max Buy. We also have TCL on the cards. Plus, of course, those two exquisite, unique, stylish Renault Kwid vehicles going to the best boxer of the league, as well as the best boxing gym as well. And so there's a lot to obviously look out for. Proud headline sponsor Deluxe, bringing you the Professional Boxing League. First bout of the evening, the referee in charge is Michael Nikwe, one of Ghana's finest when it comes to boxing referee and judges. But of course, taking a look at the judges at ringside, there's Nato Bing, there's David Mills, there's Clement Ashong, and of course, there's good old Confidence Hiagbe also here with us this evening. Good shot to the body, crowd getting behind Niashite. Going in for the clinch there, Belong. Seems to be taking a lot of the dishing of the jabs from Ni Ashilabi. Tries to counter, keeps his guard up quite well. And of course, Ni Ashilabi coming into this fight with a reach and a height advantage. Let's see whether it plays to the good for him. 10 seconds to the end of the first round. Even Stevens, so far, Cecil, let me start with you.
I mean, Prince, it's always happy to always be here whenever it comes to boxing. And it's always happy whenever we join the Deluxe Professional Boxing League. This particular bout, I can say for practically, that a Cameroonian is showing, I mean, gimmicks, but he's not actually boxing. Because you could see the anger in Ni Ashilabi that he wants to end it. But although he's also not taking his reach, he's not using his reach very well, he's taking the points as and when he gets into contact with the Cameroonian. The Cameroonian, I mean, bringing out the tongue, always coming up. He doesn't know. A straight punch can actually take him off because this is an 8-rounder. And this is also a propelling instance whereby it gives you much more in terms of getting you into that range.
Second out. Right, round.
Let's get ready for round two. First bout of the evening. It's a light heavyweight contest. And it's a Ghana-Cameroon affair. Ni Ashilabi from Ghana in the black trunks. Patrick Belong coming all the way from Douala in Cameroon. As the two boxers have a go at each other once again. Trying to penetrate with a jab that Belong. Not having any success, but of course would also want to use that to keep the distance of Ni Ashilabi. Watching closely, it's about a cross-section of Ghanaians who have come from far and near to enjoy a night of boxing. It's fight night 8, don't forget. And during the break, by the way, you saw a shot of a younger version of our former president, the late Flight Lieutenant Jerry John Rawlings. I was his son, I want to believe. So Kimathi is also here to enjoy a night of boxing. We also have a cross-section of the general public. We'll tell you who's here. But it's just the first... It's just the first night, or the first bout of the night. And we'll crisscross the crowd and tell you who's here. It's not too late to make your way here. Join us. It's almost always an exciting night of boxing here at the Bukom Boxing Arena. Professor Joshua Alabi, I think I have seen him around here somewhere. Of course, the piercing eyes of Cecil will tell us who's here. That's for sure. But we also have the leadership of our proud promoters, Max TV here. Catching my eye a while ago was Mr. Techi. Well, there you have him. And he's showing quite a lot of interest in the art of fisticuffs. Don't forget, his late father was a lover of boxing. Actually, was one of the... reasons behind the success of former WBC featherweight, super featherweight champion, Professor Azuma Nelson. So again, the boxers will have a go at each other as we get into the last 10 seconds of the second round. Nothing really to separate these two boxers. I'm not too sure if Nanayao has different thoughts, but it looks like it's close to call at this stage.
Finally, I see your face. Oh, all my days. I've been out here looking for you for days. Ooh, I just want to say, my hair, you pay for my hair. I know fit to reset. I know fit to connect within me.
Second round. Round 3.
Lots of jabbing on the part of the two boxers as we get into round 3 of the bout tonight. A little bit of a swelling on the face of Patrick Belong, just around the eyes. And again, this clearly tells us the jabbing and the heavy punches from Niashite beginning to have a telling effect on the young Cameroonian boxer. He closes in, tries to go in, and now trying to play the predator instinct. And Niashite goes in for the clinch. And it looks like Niashite has one plan and one plan only. He needs to work, or wants to work, I should say, on the swollen eye of his opponent, Belong. Belong got the all clear from the ringside doctor for mounting the ring for the second round. And he's still in there. This is round 3. A long reach of Niashite trying to clear a swollen part of the eye of Belong and waiting for that opening to cause damage to it. Belong trying to be quite effective with a block, especially coming in with a left and keeping his guard up when he has to. Showing pretty much a lot of good ring craftsmanship below. He will not wait for Ashite to come to him. And again, the Loxi Professional Boxing League has opened up opportunities for boxers who have come from across West Africa. We've seen quite a few. We've had boxers from Benin, from Togo. We're seeing today a boxer from Cameroon. It's just unfortunate he's got the swelling and team doctor has been called upon. But I think that he's given a good account of himself, at least in the first three rounds.
At least, as you said, in the first three rounds. But I don't think that we cannot see him pass maybe four rounds or five rounds.
Yeah.
Because the effectiveness with the jab from Mi Ashite, we've seen it. He's got a swollen eye, and let's see if he can take it past maybe round four, round five. Because the explosiveness from Mi Ashite's jab, we've seen it, and it's taking an effect on Patrick.
Okay, opening up at this stage, Patrick Belong, a few wild punches here and there, but works on the body of Mi Ashite. Mi Ashite stands tall. In he goes again with another of Joe's jabs. Mi Ashite keeping his guard up pretty well. Tries to size up his opponent and then delivers the right. This time he missed. We've seen a lot of resilience from Fight Night 1 when it comes to the Deluxe Professional Boxing League. This is just the first bout of the evening. But if what we're seeing is anything to go by, there will be a lot of close to call bouts.
I mean, yeah, definitely. But in this particular bout, it's a practical screening for Mi Ashite Ama, irrespective of wherever he's coming from. That's Mi Ashite Labi. Because his jab, he's using the jab very, very well. All that he needs to do is that he has to make sure that because of his long reach, he can be able to take out the Cameroonian as early as possible. Now, the jabs have actually worked on the Cameroonian. Now, I believe if he has worked his way through body punches, I don't expect us to be even touching down on round number five, because a lot of body punches with coming up with some of the straight jabs can actually take the Cameroonian out. But it seems as if he's also very, very careful about what to do and at what particular time to do it. And that is why you're still having the Cameroonian standing toe-to-toe against Mi Ashite Ama. I mean, it has been called over. The fight has been called out.
Well, it looks like the swelling has taken its effect on Patrick Belong, and we've just been given the indication that he will not be able to continue the fight. And anyway, you said it earlier on in one of your statements that from the way he's fighting, you don't think it will last him beyond round three, round four, round five.
You see, Prince, when you look at fights, when you look a lot of fights, you can see he started with clips of hopes that he can do something. With that kind of awkward style, rough fighting, going in the inside game, going with a cross overhand and stuff like that. But you know, Mi Ashite just needed that one round to figure him out. And that's what he did. The effectiveness of the jab kept on from Mi Ashite. He kept it on. His corner continued telling him, use the jab. Don't go for the inside game, because this Patrick guy wants the inside game. And Mi Ashite went for the jab and that worked it out. And you can see the swollen eye from the Cameroonian. It looks so bad and they call it off. I think that's the right call.
All right, so unfortunately, we're not going to see the expertise of Patrick Belong any longer in the bout, because he's had to retire after the round. Let's get over to Mohamed Amin Lamptey for the official verdict.
Thank you very much. Ladies and gentlemen,
it ended prematurely. That was the light heavyweight contest over six rounds. Shall we put our hands together for the two boxes? Well, we now have the verdicts. Ladies and gentlemen, in round four, by a technical knockout, the winner for the light heavyweight contest over six rounds is the man from the Beach Boxing Gymnasium here in Accra, Ni Ashiti Labi. Thank you very much. Now, let's get ready for the second bout of the evening.